July 14th marked the beginning of the Perseid meteor shower, but we are just now reaching the peak. Meteorologist Angela Huddy live in Forest Park with more on why stargazing may be the perfect family activity over the next few nights. Angela?
Yeah, Mike, with the temperatures soaring, you and your family may want to wait until after dark to do an activity, and that means you may want to spend those days, those hours, looking to the stars.
Each summer, the Perseid meteor shower graces the night sky with meteors, or bright streaks of light caused by bits of comet debris burning up in the atmosphere.
And it's one where we can count on really seeing lots of meteors or shooting stars overhead.
The Perseids peak this week, possibly bringing 30 to 50 shooting stars per hour. While the best time to view them is after midnight, you and your family don't have to stay up that late.
This is a great year for looking for the Perseids right after sunset, and part of the reason for that is that the radiant, or where a lot of these meteors will seem to come from, rises just after sunset, and even better this week is that our moon is setting right after sunset too. So the sky will be nice and dark, and if you give yourself a wide, clear view, you're definitely likely to see some meteors overhead.
To have the best view of the meteor shower, find an area with minimal light pollution and give your eyes time to adjust.
But if you do live close to lots of lights, say on your property or anywhere nearby the city, that will wash out your view of the sky, making it harder to see some of those fainter shooting stars.
With storms in our forecast Thursday, you may want to wait for the weekend to do some meteor watching. Good news, that will work out just fine.
The peak of the Perseid meteor shower does last several days. Some meteor showers have really short peaks, but even once you're a day or two afterwards, it's still worth taking a look outside, and you never know what you'll see.
So again, that's going to be the issue tonight, is the chance for the thunderstorms, the clouds that are rolling in. I can actually see a developing cumulonimbus cloud off to the northeast of where we're standing right now. But get outside this weekend as our skies clear out, lay back flat, give yourself a wide sky, and that's really going to give you the best chance to see some of these meteors right on through the weekend. I would recommend a blanket and some bug spray as you do so. Reporting live in Forest Park outside of the St. Louis Science Center's planetarium, I'm meteorologist Angela Huddy, News 11.